We're going to talk about something, clogs. It's one of the biggest discomforts you're going to run across with 3D printing. And the good news is you can prevent it most of the time if you follow some simple steps. Your number one step is you always want to make sure the heater, the extruder is heated up all the way before you start printing. And that's going to get rid of most of your clogs. The removal of the filament is very important. When you change filaments, you're going to want to heat the extruder up all the way. You're actually going to extrude for about 5 seconds and then immediately reverse and pull the filaments out. And that will prevent a lot of clogs. Another thing is if you're using two different types of filaments, say you're using ABS and then PLA, or even if you're changing colors, there could be some different characteristics of the filament. Let's say you're printing ABS at 260 degrees Celsius. You just pull it out of the machine. If you put PLA in there and print at 220 degrees Celsius, some of the ABS may not be as melted the same way as the PLA is going to be, and then you could get clogs there. So when you change the filament, you always want to clean the extruder by plunging out the old filament first before you put a new filament in. And now, if you actually run across a clog after you do all these prevention things, I'm going to tell you how to the most easily get rid of the clog, and I'll explain that right now. Okay, to clean the extruder, you don't necessarily have to take the top plate off. You can get at it without doing that, but I'm just going to take it off just so that we can see the inside of the machine better. So I'm going to start doing that now. I'm going to use the trusty Allen wrench that came with the Allen wrench set with the CraftBot kit. Now we're at the point we're going to do the easiest way to clean a clog out, or even to clean out extra filament in the extruder if you're changing the filament types. You're going to go to your LCD menu, click on axes, you're going to home in, you're going to go to the directional command, and you're going to lower the z-axis all the way. And the reason we're doing this is we want to have the most room to get to the extruder as possible. And we don't want that bed in the way. If we can get it out of the way, that's the best thing to do. So we'll lower this all the way down. Okay, at this point, we can just flip the machine off and unplug it, because we never want to reach inside the machine while it's on, just to prevent terrible injuries or bad things from happening. At this point, you're able to move the extruder freely because the motors aren't on. And what we want to do is we want to disconnect the fan unit. And to do this, you're just going to take these two top things, you're going to loosen them up, the two nuts up here with an Allen wrench, which came with your set, and this will pop right off. Now you're going to see there's a connection here, and what we're going to do is we're just going to come down here and disconnect it with our hand, and it'll pop right off, and put this in a safe place. Now that we have the fan assembly off, we're actually going to come in here and take this little gear out just to get better access. You're going to use your smallest Allen wrench, and if you see there's a little set screw on the side, you're going to put the Allen wrench in there, and you're just going to pop that right off. You're not going to take the set screw out, but just loosen it up, it'll slide right off. And a lot of times when you have a clog, you'll actually see filament stuck in the teeth of the gear. And you can use two main ways to clean it out, a toothbrush and a little pin or needle works very well. You always want to make sure it's cleaned out before you put it back on, but for now we're going to put it in a safe place. At this point in time, we're actually going to flip the machine on. I put the extruder off to the side so that the filament, once it heats up, is not going to drip on the bed itself. Now I'm going to power it up. When the machine comes on, we're going to go down to the LCD. And we're going to heat this up as high as it will go, which will be 260 degrees Celsius. The easy way to do that is to set for ABS, go into the temperature, bring it up to 260. We'll go back out, and we'll actually press the heat up button. And it's going to start heating up to 260 degrees Celsius. Just leave the bed off. Don't press that, because why would you want that on? It doesn't make any sense. So now we'll wait till it heats up. Now, what I'm going to do is I'm going to come in and flip the lever over, and this will just loosen it up just a little bit, just for the heck of it. I have the smallest Allen wrench that comes with the set, and I'm going to use this to actually come down here and plunge
any filament out, and if I stick it down in there, it should, some of the excess filament you'll see in the bottom actually coming out, and you just want to get it plunged out there as good as you can. And once you get that all cleaned out, you can put your next filament in there, and hopefully that'll clean the clog. And in case there's a more intense clog than this, I'm going to show you the next step, how to take care of that. Okay, for a more intense clog, we do have to have the machine on and reach in. So you have to make extra sure you have as much space in here as possible. The Z-axis is lowered all the way down. And you're going to want to heat the extruder all the way up to 260. The hot end is going to be heated up, and we're going to have three tools, three main things. We're going to have a wrench that we can grab onto this rubber red part with. We're going to have another 7mm wrench, which will actually go around the nozzle, and we're going to take it off with that. And most importantly, we want protection for our hands, an oven mitt or something like that that we can actually use, because this is very hot and it will burn you. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to reach in here and I'm going to put this wrench around here. Now the reason you want to hold this as firm as you can is because the heater wires and the temp sensor wires are actually running into this. Now you're going to reach in here while the power is on, so you want to make sure you have the most room in here, and if something happens you want to be able to pull out real quick, because we never recommend coming in and working on the inside of the machine, but in this situation we actually have to have it heated up to get the nozzle off, because the filament needs to be liquefied or else it'll stick and create a bond which we won't be able to pry it off with. So at this point, when we're holding this as firm as we can, not trying to turn it because we don't want to break the wires, we're going to take our other wrench and put it around here. All right, so it's fallen off, and now we can actually take that smallest Allen wrench, come back from the top, we have the gear off, we have this loosened up, we have the fan assembly off already, and we can put this in and actually plunge it out all the way and get it much cleaner than it would the other way. And you could even come up from the bottom and do the same thing. Watch out, because it could burn you. Make sure you have hand protection on. I'm just doing a simulation here. And you can actually put it up to the bottom and do the same thing.